and Lynch.
Stay up to date with your trusted and relevant source in news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 9:01, it's 35 degrees, a high today of 41, rain, snow mix once again, and it'll continue into tonight, a low down to 33. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Adam Roberts. Happening today, a candidate announcing her run for Mike Gallagher's open congressional seat. Gallagher announcing he would resign from the 8th District seat later this month. And so today, Democrat Kristen Lierley, an OBGYN, will announce her run for Gallagher's open seat at an event at Hinterland in Green Bay. Lierley set to join WTMJ Spanning the State today at 1:15. Other stories we're keeping an eye on today. A six-year-old still in critical condition this morning after a crash Wednesday near 27th and Cleveland on Milwaukee's south side. The driver of a silver Nissan running a red light at the intersection, striking a blue Dodge. Janet Rebels lives nearby, telling TMJ4 News she's seen this play out far too often.
To me, they're not doing enough to deter the reckless driving. We will literally just go through the intersection. We don't even try to turn on that intersection.
Police arresting a 34-year-old female driver of the Nissan. Charges are pending. The Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office confirming a leg found near Warnemont Park in Cudahy is, in fact, from a human. Resident going for a walk in the park calling 911 Tuesday evening after discovering the leg. Resident John Hammer tells TMJ4 News he's in shock and frequents the park often.
Unbelievable. My dog and I come here all the time to walk. I golf here at Warnemont all the time. I grew up here. It's really a shocking crime. I've never seen or heard of anything like this in Cudahy before, ever.
Authorities say they are investigating this as a death and not a homicide. Overseas, more pressure on Israel's government over the airstrike on that World Central Kitchen convoy, and more pressure on some of the leaders doing the pressuring.
I'm Vicky Barker in London. More than 600 legal experts here in the UK, including three former Supreme Court justices, have written to Prime Minister Rishi Sunak calling for Britain to end arms sales to Israel or risk violating international law over what they call, quote, the plausible risk of genocide in Gaza. The UK's arms exports to Israel are just a fraction of what the US sends, but a ban would put more pressure on Israel over its actions in Gaza. Sunak, though, so far resisting a ban. Vicky Barker, CBS News, London.
Time for news about your money. The WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update at this hour, so it's all green for the majors. The Dow is up 169 points to 39,296, while the S&P 500 up 37 to 5,248, and the NASDAQ up 142 points this morning to 16,419. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. Details at annexwealth.com. Sports, traffic, and weather coming up next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 9:04.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you the spring supplies you need because we get you. For farms and projects of any size, find the right products at the right prices. Like 2.5 gallons of Clean Def, just $8.49. 2,000-pound Champion ATV-UTV winch kits, $79.99. Rewards members save an extra $10. Better-built truck boxes, 10% off. Rewards members save 15%. Plus, join us in Madison, Wisconsin for the Midwest Horse Fair. Stop by the Blaine's Farm and Fleet booths for discounts, giveaways, and more.
When a new baby is added to the mix, saving money becomes a real priority. Shopping at St. Vincent de Paul thrift stores can help. With an abundance of baby clothing and toys, all thrift store priced at pennies on the dollar, you'll spend a little to get a lot. Find great deals on gently used baby clothes and toys at St. Vincent de Paul thrift stores on Highway 100 in Layton and Greenfield and 23rd in Lincoln in Milwaukee.
Ooh, you're gonna love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
Outdoor living is great, but it's best when it's at your own home. Well, there's a company called Outdoor Living Unlimited that will build you a deck, a patio, pergola, fire pit, all manner of things to enhance outdoor living at your place, even an outdoor kitchen. Get started right away. Contact Outdoor Living Unlimited now. Get your yard project onto Outdoor Living Unlimited's calendar while there's still openings. OutdoorLivingUnlimited.com.
You want to feel important. You want to be a part of something bigger, something that matters and can help change things. You want to feel like you belong. We know. We felt that way too. And that's why we did something about it. We aren't just Army National Guard soldiers. We are normal people just like you. And together, we can make a difference. Take on your legacy. Visit NationalGuard.com to find out more.
Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
Time for a WTMJ Sports Update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All. Sports Desk, another tough loss for the Bucks. Their second straight to a team they probably should have beaten. 111-101 last night against the Grizzlies. That's now 4 out of 5 losses for the Bucks in their last 5 games. They'll next be in action tomorrow evening at home against the Raptors. And the Brewers off today following their first loss of the season Wednesday to Minnesota. Back at home on Friday, tomorrow, starting a 3-game series against the Mariners. Check the roads, your WTMJ Johnson and Sons Paving, Time Saver Traffic. Got a couple of broken down vehicles, one on 94 North near Rawson, and also one on 94 West in Waukesha County, right near Moreland Road. The real story, though, remains the wet roads and some slow spots. Very slow right now out of the Mitchell over to the Loomis Construction Zone site on 894 West, and also slow around the Hale Curve from 894 South heading east. It's slow as well from the zoo to the stadium on 94 East, about an extra couple minutes on that drive, and still a bit slow on 43 North and South between Silver Spring and Fond du Lac.
Traffic is sponsored by the Heiser Automotive Group. For convenient car shopping and financing, visit Heiser Automotive Group at one of their 4 locations, Toyota, Chevy, Ford, Lincoln, and Cadillac, or visit Heiser.com, because today's your day.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast, rain, snow mix already starting to work its way north to south this morning, continuing into the afternoon, a high of 41. Could continue as well into the overnight, down to 33 for the low. Decrease in clouds for your Friday, 43, mostly sunny then on Saturday. One of those cooler by the lake days, 46 lakeside, 50 inland. Rain chances return though for Sunday, a high of 46. More rain possible Monday, but it will be a bit warmer, high around 55 degrees. Right now in Madison, snowy conditions and 34. Still snowing up in Green Bay, 33 there. Waukesha, 32 with light snow. And in Milwaukee, rain, snow mix and 35 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts, signing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 908.
Good morning, Wisconsin. So let's pour that coffee and talk to some experts about what's going on in Milwaukee, Madison, Washington, and beyond. Broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. It's the Political Power Hour on WTMJ. Here's your host, Steve Scafidi.
Should we talk about the government?
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the legal edition, sort of the one of 5 different variations on a theme, Political Power Hour, is the show. I'm your host, Steve Scafidi, and a special guest today joining us on the phone, Rick Esselberg, president of the Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty. Good morning, Rick.
Good morning, Steve. How are you doing?
I am good on this Thursday. All right, so let's get right to the big stuff that happened in Wisconsin. There's a lot of other things we're going to talk about in the next 45 minutes. So I'm going to give you some of the contrary and opinion to what you or I am. Presuming we're sort of thinking alike on this, is the constitutional amendments an appeasement of sorts to election deniers in Wisconsin?
Well, no. I think that the referenda were really an instantiation of that old thing about following what you learned in kindergarten. And, you know, elections are hotly contested. They have winners and losers, and it's very important that the losers accept the outcome. This tremendous problem following the 2020 presidential election because the Republican candidate wouldn't accept the outcome. And in order to facilitate people accepting the outcome, our election administration has to be rigorously neutral. And having private parties fund elections is likely to result in those elections being funded by people who are interested in the outcome and who, while they may not commit fraud, may well spend that money in ways that intentionally or not advance their interests, right? Support the side that they want to support. And there was evidence with the CTCL funding that that's exactly what happened. The money went disproportionately to heavily populated areas. It wasn't per capita. You know, Milwaukee got more than its additional population warrant. They went disproportionately to areas that voted heavily for Democrats. And in some instances, at least, CTCL embedded people who looked like partisan activists within city government to conduct get-out-the-vote operations. Now, even if they didn't do anything wrong, even if they didn't break the law, this looks bad. Right? This looks like working the refs. And so I think it's sort of elementary and pretty simple that we ought not to allow that.
How active was Will, Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty, in getting these amendments on the ballot? Were you asked about it? Were you providing information, data? Were you involved?
We testified in favor of the first question. We were more involved, I think, in the legislation that was passed by and then vetoed by the governor, which would have allowed WEC to accept private funds, and then they would be obligated to distribute it on an even-handed basis to the localities. We certainly did support the amendment once it was on the ballot, and we did some things to get that message out.
One of the big, even though I may agree with the results of the amendments, one of the problems I have, and you and I have talked about this before, these sort of end runs around the normal process, which is the legislature passes the laws, governor signs them, that's it. But we constantly are now churning through court case after court case, constitutional amendments. Is this really the best way, the most effective way to govern ourselves?
Well let me give you a little context here and some interesting factoids. So the Wisconsin Constitution is now 176 years old. It is the oldest state constitution outside of New England. It's, I think, sixth in the country. And so we've kept our constitution much, much longer than almost any other state. However, we've amended it a lot. The Wisconsin Constitution has been amended over 100 times over the course of those 176 years. So the average, better than an amendment every 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's not as unusual as you might think. And the reason that we do it is when, at least if we're doing it right, we want to take a principle and we want to move it out of the ordinary democratic process. So, for example, we wouldn't want the legislature to be, voting on whether or not people can now be discriminated against on the basis of their race. We wouldn't want the legislature to be voting on whether we're going to recognize, free speech in this biennium, right? These are foundational principles. And here I think we have what we're trying to do is provide some constitutional support for the principle that election administration has to be neutral. And that principle shouldn't vary from biennia to biennia, depending upon whether the Democrats or the Republicans are in control. But this is a principle which should really be above the daily political fray.
Rick Esselberg is our guest on the Political Power Hour. He's going to be here till about 9:45 or so. So if you have a question you'd like to get into the show, I'll try to do my best to do that. 855-616-1620. Text will be just fine. I'm going to ask Rick this question after the break, so I'll give Rick a chance to think about it. Shouldn't we have the same rules across the state in every municipality, every county when it comes to our elections? We'll hash that one out after this on WTMJ.
Hot dog, get your hot dogs here. Hot and fresh hot dogs.
Hot diggity dog, it's baseball season. Wisconsin's Afternoon News has partnered up with Vienna Beef to bring you Brewers Ticket Tuesday.
Tune in every Tuesday during the 3 o'clock hour for your chance to win a pair of tickets for an upcoming Tuesday home game for the Milwaukee Brewers.
Nothing says summer like a hot dog and baseball, and we've got both on Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
On the home of the Brewers, WTMJ.
Hey, this is WTMJ, Steve Scafidi for Avid. I love talking about Avid because they changed my life. They can change yours. snoring issues, tossing and turning, restless nights of sleep, all the things that lead to a very tired, sometimes grouchy morning, that does not have to be your reality. I went to Advent, one of the great facilities, in a quick visit with two of their docs, put me at ease. We agreed to do a simple sleep study at home in my own bed. They determined my problem, sinuses, nasal passages in my breathing triangle. They took care of business. Short procedure done in office and back to breathing better than ever. My wife and I sleeping through the whole night. Another great night's sleep last night. That's why I'm in such a good mood today. If you struggle with restless nights like I did and we did, take the time to see how Advent can help you. To find out how breathing well and sleeping well can make your nights better, go to AdventKnows.com and schedule an appointment today, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Tune in on Sundays at 10 a.m. for the Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show. Join Acunet's Brian and David Wickard for the most up-to-date information on mortgage trends, along with timely news on the real estate market. The housing market is in flux, but the national headlines don't often fit local market conditions. Find out what's really happening on the front lines of real estate and mortgage financing in Wisconsin and make better decisions by tuning in every Sunday at 10 a.m. The Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show with Brian and David Wickard on WTMJ.
Continuing our conversation with Rick Esberg, president of Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty. Always enjoy my conversations with Rick. All right, Rick. I heard from a listener the other day when they knew that I was going to be talking to you, and they wanted me to bring this up. So apparently there are widespread differences in the hours that early voting is open. Some in the case of this listener, and I have not verified this, they said they don't even have early voting in their community. Shouldn't we have the same rules when it comes to all of these allowances on how the public wants to vote be consistent across the states?
Yeah, I don't know whether that's right, that there's no early voting, but I think that there is much to be said about having uniform rules, because this really goes back in some ways to the whole CTCL and private funding thing. In statewide elections, we want a neutral playing field. Like we don't want it to be substantially easier or harder to vote in Madison or Milwaukee than it is in the rest of the state. We want to keep things more or less equal. There is some advantage in having elections run locally, that is, having each clerk involved, because it can have the effect of making voter fraud much more difficult, because if you were dead set on doing something nefarious to influence a statewide election, you now have to deal with clerks in a lot of different locations. And, one of my rules of life is that conspiracies will never work if they have to involve a lot of people, because somebody will talk, somebody will make a mistake. And so having elections decentralized in that way with respect to who's running them may be a good thing. There should be uniformity of rules, and we do have a system in Wisconsin, which is a little bit of a kludge in that regard. We used to have totally decentralized operation of elections, and over the years we've sort of moved to a more centralized system where we have a centralized we have a centralized voter roll and voter registration . But yet there are things that are still within the province of local clerks. And so we saw that in the case about the statutory obligation to remove people who have moved from the voter rolls. This is a state obligation. It's imposed by state statute. But yet the Supreme Court ruled that it is the job of the individual clerks and not of WEC. And so sometimes we get anomalies because the system has been put together over the years by a series of iterative amendments. They would change the law in this way one year, and then a couple of years later they would change it, all moving in the direction of a more centralized system. But there are still areas in which that hasn't really been accomplished.
Rick Esselberg, my guest on the Political Power Hour on WTMJ, the legal hour of that five-day program, Monday through Friday night at 10. I've talked to a lot of city and county clerks over the last 4 years, and one of the things they always remind me, because you and I have talked about this extensively, all the theories about, you know, people voting more than once or voting in the wrong place or dead people voting. Clerks always reminded that every ballot is checked to make sure that there is a person behind that vote and there's not one person voting 10 times. And in the very rare cases where that happens, those cases are prosecuted, and eventually those people are convicted. So I guess the reality of this political world we live in, people can say whatever they want, but in reality, one person, one votes, and I trust, like I think you do as well, the results in 2020. Doesn't mean they're perfect. No election's perfect, but I trust the end result. Do you feel the same way?
I think that voter fraud... I think it's very, very, very possible to engage in low-volume voter fraud in the state of Wisconsin. I mean, we allow same-day registration with proof of residency, which is easily fabricated. The voter ID requirement, although you actually don't have to have an ID to register, but the fact that then in order to cast a vote in person, you have to show that ID, I think operates to put a check on that. But, you know, if somebody was careful and wanted to vote a couple of times in the state of Wisconsin, they could manage that, and the likelihood that they'll get caught is very, very small because, you know, we try to verify those registrations, but then when, you know, they come back and nobody's living at that address, or that address turns out to be, you know, a vacant lot, there's not a lot of follow-up that that is done. There's not a lot of follow-up that's even possible. However, it's very hard to do that at scale for the reason that I mentioned earlier. I mean, if you wanted to do that at scale, you'd have to involve a lot of people, and in all likelihood, somebody would talk, you'd get caught. Or, and this is something that we did in our report after the 2020 election, there would be some anomaly somewhere. There would be something where you could look at the results and you could say that can't be right. And so while voter fraud can certainly happen, it's very difficult to do it in numbers that would sway most elections. It's still something you have to be concerned about because if you don't have adequate safeguards in place, you'll get more of it. It will be easier to accomplish. And sometimes there are really, really close races statewide and certainly on the local level. So you still have to have, you know, adequate safeguards in place. You still have to be concerned about election integrity. But most elections are well beyond the margin of fraud. I mean, the 2020 presidential election was decided by 20,000 votes out of 3 million. That's a really, really close election.
Mm-hmm.
But to sway a 20,000 vote election through fraud, be very, very difficult.
We'll take a break here. Rick Esselberg, after the break, the all-important ballot box question, right? Will this happen? The Supreme Court in Wisconsin is going to take up that case. We've got a big election primary in August and a general in November. So we will have that conversation with Rick Esselberg, my guest on the Political Power Hour on WTMJ.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Burkhart Sporting Goods in New Berlin is the baseball lover's destination. With a massive state-of-the-art indoor training facility featuring hit tracks with precision analytics, a huge open turf area, and all the best training equipment you need. So get in here and get ready to get better. And we'll help you with this special offer. Buy 20 batting cage credits for $30. That's 25% off. This is Brian Burkhart, and if you love baseball and softball like we do,
you can't beat Burkhart.
153rd and National. If you plan on draining buzzer beaters, the place to start is Burkhart, where you'll find a great selection of residential basketball hoops from the best brand, Gorilla. We'll handle the installation and take care of everything to make it easy from start to finish. And right now, when you buy from Burkhart, standard hoop installation is half price. Only $250 for standard installation. You can't beat that. This is Brian Burkhart, and when you love basketball like we do,
you can't beat Burkhart.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
I know you have a great dog, right? But you know there's room for improvement. At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we can help. Our attention-based training system uses modern technology to help you better communicate with your dog, even in high distraction. When you schedule a free consultation with us, you will have the opportunity to see our training in action and meet for yourself our happy dogs off-leash and under control. Contact Sit Means Sit today at 262-361-3641 or find us on the web at sitmeanssitwaukesha.com to schedule your free consultation so you can have a happy, confident, and obedient dog.
The sooner you address your joint pain, the better. You really don't want your pain to become chronic, to a point when surgery may become your only option. Address your joint pain issues early and calm down that inflammation and increase your mobility. Get the joints moving again and the blood circulating. That can be very beneficial. Plus, why not just feel better sooner? By coming to Rejuvenix, at the very least we can alleviate your pain so you can feel and move better to help you live a better quality of life. Don't you deserve at least that? Multi-joint treatments at Rejuvenix can cost as little as, well, nothing. That's because we are in-network with almost all major insurance plans, including Medicare and Medicaid. So you really have nothing to lose, except a very good chance of living with a lot less pain. This is Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenix Arthritis Clinics, where we can alleviate your pain and rejuvenate your life. Go to Rejuvenix.com to request your appointment.
Latest news from Adam Roberts and the latest from ABC coming up at 9:30. But before we get to that, Rick Esselberg continuing that conversation. Rick, you said before, you and I have talked before, that these ballot drop boxes, you don't see any language that says they're legal. If that's the case, Rick, how can any judge, Supreme Court or otherwise, be able to legalize them? That question is being asked as we speak.
Well, I don't know. We'll see. But let me do this. Let me just tell you what the law says. Right? If you go to the statute which governs return of absentee ballots, it talks about how you have to fill the ballot out, how you have to place it into an envelope, and then it says, the envelope shall be mailed by the elector or delivered in person to the municipal clerk issuing the ballot of ballots. So it's actually pretty clear. It says that you return it either by putting it in the mail. It means you can't send it by UPS. You can't send it by FedEx. Or you deliver it in person to the clerk. Those are the two ways. No other ways are permitted. And that includes drop boxes. And so if you think drop boxes are the greatest thing since sliced bread and you want them, you got to change the law. And judges, at least if they're acting like judges, don't have the power to do that. Now, judges are lawyers, and lawyers are very, very good at manipulating language and making arguments that it means something other than what it quite clearly says. But I don't see a path here to argue that state law permits drop boxes. It doesn't.
He is Rick Esselberg talking about all the legalities and the constitutional amendments, ballot drop boxes, and then after the break for news, we're going to talk about some of the developments in the Trump trials, as I call them, and others do as well. Any danger for the president? What's the legal issue with presidential immunity? The criminal trial starting in a couple weeks. Is that a serious risk for the president? And we'll examine with Rick Esselberg some of the critical questions on whether those charges will hold up. Could the president be acquitted? Lots of things to talk about in our remaining time with the president of the Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty, Rick Esselberg, and even the Georgia case, Fannie Willis. Is that thing going to survive to trial? Because there's a lot of trials and tribulations, to borrow that term in that case as well. Any of this be resolved in quick fashion? I'll answer the question myself. I don't think so. And will it involve the president actually being convicted before the election? Here's the latest from Adam Roberts. Before we get to that, the latest from ABC News.
ABC News, I'm Brian Clark. President Biden will speak today to Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. It'll be their first conversation since Israel's military strike that killed 7 aid workers in Gaza. ABC's Mary Bruce has more from the White House.
President Biden will be speaking with Prime Minister Netanyahu in what is expected and likely to be a very tense call. Look, President Biden, we know, is outraged and he says heartbroken by these killings. In his strongest rebuke yet this week, he accused Israel of simply not doing enough to protect civilians.
Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen is in China at the start of bilateral economic talks. Severe storms are now blamed for at least 5 deaths in the U.S. The weather now dumping snow in New England where hundreds of thousands don't have power. And the American Cancer Society estimates by 2050, 15 million more people will be diagnosed with cancer, blaming aging and population growth. But they say many of these cases could be prevented with healthier lifestyles. This is ABC News.
Signing Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 9:31. Decision Wisconsin, Green Bay OBGYN Kristen Lyerly will announce her campaign for outgoing U.S. Congressman Mike Gallagher's seat later this morning at an event at Hinterland Brewing in Green Bay. Gallagher will step down from his position as head of the 8th Congressional District later this month. Two Republicans, former State Senator Roger Roth and State Senator Andre Jacques, have already announced their candidacies. Lyerly will join with WTMJ spanning the state at 1:15 this afternoon. The boyfriend of missing Elijah Vu's mother is in court today for a preliminary hearing. Jesse Vang, along with Vu's mother, Katrina Bauer, have both been charged with child neglect but are still not charged in Vu's disappearance. Bauer will be back in court April 26th. Vu has now been missing since February 20th. And the first extension of Milwaukee's Hop streetcar will begin service 7 days a week on April 11th. That includes making stops at the Couture High Rises Transit Center, which will also serve as the eastern endpoint for the Milwaukee County Transit System's Connect One bus rapid transit line. Time for news about your money. The WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update still green for the majors right now. 163 points up is the Dow Jones at 39,290, while the S&P 500 up 36 points this hour to 5,247, and the NASDAQ is up 135 to 16,413. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com and click on the Get Started button now. Checking the roads, your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. Some of those earlier delays we were seeing on 94 East and West have since dissipated a bit, but roads are still very slick through that stretch as rain and snow continues to fall. It's also still slow on 43 North from about North Avenue up to Capitol Drive right now, and still slow through the construction zone on 894 West from the Plainfield Curve all the way over right now to about Forest Home. And your WTMJ forecast for today, that rain and snow continuing throughout the morning into the afternoon as well. High of 41 today, will also be breezy out there. Rain-snow mix continues tonight in a low of 33. Decreasing clouds for your Friday and 43. Mostly sunny Saturday, 46 near the lake, 50 inland. Chance of showers Sunday and 46. More rain possible Monday, but warmer, a high of 55 degrees. Right now in Oshkosh, snow falling and 34. In Wauwatosa, heavy band of snow right now moving through in 33. And in Milwaukee, snow showers and 35 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Times, 9:34.
Good news, bad news. The good news, inflation today is nothing like it's been in the past few years. The bad news, lower inflation doesn't mean lower prices. In fact, one recent study says investors still consider inflation their single biggest threat. If you're concerned how inflation might affect your legacy, your financial freedom, or your confidence, meet with the team at Annex Wealth Management. We're fee-only fiduciaries. We'll build a plan together and guide you on the steps to take to reach the retirement you desire. Annex Wealth Management. Know the difference. AnnexWealth.com.
Get the help you need Saturday morning with How To Radio. At 7, it's the WTMJ Fix-It Show with David Nason, featuring this week's guests, Milwaukee Neri and Siding Unlimited. At 9, plan your dream vacation with the Fox World Travel Show. And at 10, get financial guidance during Money Talk. Contact Annex Wealth Management for an unbiased review of your investments at AnnexWealth.com. How To Radio, Saturday mornings on WTMJ.
Join veteran political strategists Donna Brazil and Anna Navarro on April 9th for an animated political discussion at UWM Waukesha. Donna Brazil is a New York Times best-selling author, former interim chair of the DNC, and ran Al Gore's presidential campaign in 2000. Anna Navarro was national co-chair of John McCain's Hispanic Advisory Council and worked on his 2008 campaign. Presented by the Tommy G. Thompson Center on Public Leadership, a political evening with Donna Brazil and Anna Navarro at UWM Waukesha. Learn more at uwm.edu/politics2024.
Hey, John Merkier here with my friend Joe Shutman, the owner of Sidex Windows, Siding, and Baths, who tells me it's not so much about the product, it's about the customers.
At the end of the day, this is a people business.
Sidex did my bathroom and transformed it by taking out a bathtub and putting in a gorgeous walk-in shower.
We got to make people happy at the end of the day, and that only works by getting it done right.
Joe took over the business when his dad passed away, and carrying on his legacy is what it's all about.
Nothing's more important to me.
It's Sidex. S-I-D-E-X. Like excellence. Check out SidexRemodel.com.
Continue our conversation with Rick Essenberg, president of Wisconsin Institute for Law and Liberty. Rick joining us on the phone. All right, Rick, so it's not my turn, but Trump trials, Manhattan, U.S. case, United States for Donald Trump in the state of Florida, Jack Smith. Let's start with the Manhattan case. I guess my general question is there real danger here for this, for the president, former President Donald Trump? This is a criminal case, a very quick timeline, relatively so, because all the other cases seem to be dragging out a bit, although you would probably tell me this is the normal process for all of these things. What do you make? Let's start with the Manhattan one. What do you make of that case?
Well, the case is garbage. But let me tell you.
Oh, do we lose Rick there? Rick, you're breaking up a little bit.
Is this better?
Yeah, all right, we got you.
Okay. I think the case is garbage, legal garbage, but it does pose threats to the president, and here's why. I mean, the case is bad. I'm actually aware of no lawyer whose opinion I respect who actually doesn't believe that the Manhattan case is a really bad case. Because what Trump is being accused of is essentially lying to his checkbook. He did not report the payoff to the stripper as a payoff to the stripper. But
oh, I think we lost. We're losing you a bit, Rick.
Let me see if I try to make that better. Legally, it's a bad charge, and there's a lot of reasons for that, and we can get into it. However, Judge Mershon is apparently going to let that case go to the jury. And the jury not be asked whether this is a legally supportable charge. They'll be asked whether he did it or not. And he did do it.
But he's admitted to basically doing it.
Yeah, right, right. And so because they are not asked to pass on the legal adequacy of the charge, the only way Trump can really win is, ironically, by jury nullification. He has to convince the jury this is just a stupid case. The district attorney in a city that's got too much crime is wasting his money chasing, you know, something that really isn't that important. But if they don't do that, if they follow the instructions that Mershon is going to give them, they'll probably return a guilty verdict.
So what's the implication of that? Is it a guilty verdict that says this person shouldn't be president, or is it just a guilty verdict like anything else that where, well, he's guilty, but he's still going to run for president, and he still might win the election? What's the significance of it?
He's still going to run for president, and he still might win the election, because the guilty verdict itself doesn't bar him from running for president. Now, you have all of these sort of difficult issues that arise because, well, you know, what happens if he's – you wouldn't think that this is a type of thing that would result in confinement in jail, but what if it does, and how do you – through that, and how quickly is that going to happen, and is it going to go up on appeal? I think in the long run, any conviction would probably be set aside, but you could have one, and you could have it, you know, well before the election.
The Florida case, United States versus of America versus Donald Trump, documents case. There's a co-defendant, Walt Nauta, his kind of his valet, and I think there's a maintenance person involved. A lot of people think that was the strongest case, but yet we have a judge in that case who seems to be either confused about the law, and now she's being challenged by Jack Smith. What do you make of that one?
Well, I think that is the strongest case. I think that legally, it's a defensible charge. And once again, there's no dispute about the facts. He did it. And the problem there is that because this involves classified information, trying the case is a nightmare. Getting ready to try the case is a nightmare. And I still don't believe that that's going to happen before the election. And it's complicated by the fact, however, that that Joe Biden basically did the same thing. And you can draw distinctions, you know, Biden came clean, Trump resisted coming clean, but, you know, that really goes to a second offense.
Well, I mean, I'm not an attorney, but cooperation generally means you get a little more leniency.
Yeah, but you don't get off.
You don't get off, but you get more leniency.
And he's getting off, or at least that is the recommendation that the special counsel made. And so politically, it might not have the impact that it otherwise might have because.
Let's do this. Let's take a break. We'll reconnect with Rick after the break. You're listening, of course, to the Political Power Hour on WTMJ.
Tune in on Sundays at 10 a.m. for the Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show. Join Acunet's Brian and David Wickard for the most up-to-date information on mortgage trends, along with timely news on the real estate market. The housing market is in flux, but the national headlines don't often fit local market conditions. Find out what's really happening on the front lines of real estate and mortgage financing in Wisconsin and make better decisions by tuning in every Sunday at 10 a.m. The Acunet Mortgage and Realty Show with Brian and David Wickard on WTMJ.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve's Committee. For the Bath Authority, just had them out at my house. You will love the experience. They answered every question. Almost 2 hours at our house. Whether your bath or shower is outdated, whether you got some other problems, mold or mildew, you got to call my friends at the Bath Authority. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, all Bath Authority products. Brandon made this point very clear the other day. 100% made in the USA and can be installed as quickly as one day. Here's the number. I'm going to give it to you twice. 414-249-6934. One more time. 414-249-6934. Schedule your free in-home estimate today. They'll walk through all different things you can do with your bathrooms. And if you call today, $1,000 off your new shower or bath. Plus, get this. If you need it, 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. A better bath awaits.
Vince Vitrano for Connect Chiropractic. Dr. Alex and his team have my neck, back, and shoulder feeling so much better. One of my fellow patients, Missy, said she actually went in with a slight limp a year ago. That's now gone. I met Tom in the lobby the other day. Said he came in to Connect Chiro after another doc wasn't helping him feel better. Now he's found his home for chiropractic care. You're invited. Open house Wednesday, April 24th, 6 to 8 p.m. at the office in Wauwatosa. Meet the doc, see the place, and learn how chiropractic care can help you. Go Connect Chiro. That's GoConnectChiro.com.
The pulse of the Milwaukee Bucks, straight from a Bucks legend.
Can't get it off. Marcus Johnson will, though. Can't leave him alone for a 12th.
Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson on Bucks Plus. Marcus and his son Chris offer a weekly beat on Bucks basketball. Get your questions answered and hear from the biggest names in basketball. Find Hear District with Marcus Johnson at Bucks.com/plus on the Bucks app or wherever you get your podcasts.
If you're like me, you always like to add a little something new to the wardrobe. But when money's tight, it makes it harder. And that's why you shop at St. Vincent de Paul for a terrific selection of women's clothing at thrift store prices. Brand names, too. With a selection that's always up to date and looking great, you're going to find something cute at the right price, and you're going to love it. St. Vincent de Paul thrift stores on Highway 100 in Layton and Greenfield and 23rd in Lincoln in Milwaukee.
Ooh, you're going to love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
Find furniture for life from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. When you're ready to get out and prep your yard for spring, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $15 gift card with a $100 purchase of Scotts products. Like Scotts Turf Builder Lawn Food, $49.99 after sale and mail-in rebate. Scotts Grub X Season Long Grub Killer, $24.99 after sale and rebate. And save $2 on select bags of Miracle-Gro Potting Mix. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Couple minutes remaining with Rick Esselberg, president of Wisconsin Institute of Law and Liberty. Hopefully we have a good connection, Rick. A couple quick ones before we get to the end of our conversation. The Georgia case, Fannie Willis, is this thing going to ever survive to trial?
You know, the problem with the Willis prosecution is it are also all legal. And they're worse than the Smith prosecution because she tried to make it too complicated to To quote one of my colleagues, there's too much French pastry in there. She decided to, you know, use these complicated RICO charges, which she didn't have to. And it just seems like the thing is sort of collapsing under its own weight, aided by, you know, her own kind of incomprehensible personal behavior. I don't know that this one definitely isn't going to go to trial before the election. And I don't know if it's ever going to get there.
All right. I know you've argued cases in front of the Wisconsin Supreme Court. The U.S. Supreme Court has some big things to decide. One of those is this question of presidential immunity, which kind of, you know, will involve some of the other pieces of these other cases. Is this going to be resolved in any sort of a quick fashion? They're talking June. You think that's realistic? Is that going to happen?
I think so. I think you're going to see it before the end of the term for sure. And I think that the court is going to say that the D.C. Circuit's view of presidential immunity was too narrow, but Trump's view is too broad. And they're going to set forth a standard for presidential immunity. And then the question will be, does it apply to the stuff that Trump did following the 2020 election?
If that's what they decide or rule. Do you agree with that ruling? I mean, is that something you're comfortable with?
Well, I think that there has to be some immunity for presidents, right? We don't, you know, federal criminal law is really, really complicated. There's a law professor who once said, if you're over 18 in the United States, you probably could be indicted under some federal statute because all sorts of things are prohibited. They're very, very vague. They can be misused. And so you want to give the president some type of immunity so that he or she can do the job and not worry about being prosecuted when the other party comes into power. However, I think that there are very good arguments that immunity shouldn't apply to what happened following the November election. I think that the bigger problem for Jack Smith and Fannie Willis is that much of what Trump did, maybe all of what Trump did, is actually speech and protected by the First Amendment.
That is the big question.
Even though it was bad speech.
Right.
You know, but it's still protected.
Rick Esser, I always enjoy our conversations. We'll do it again down the road.
All right. Take care, Steve.
All right. We'll take one final break, and then I'll give you some thoughts as we wind it up to the top of the hour news. And, of course, the upswing with Jeff Sherman follows our top of the hour news right here on WTMJ.
When we're out in your town, come say hi to us as we broadcast live from the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin mobile studio.
Anytime you hear us when we're out on the road, you can find us live from our brand new mobile studio.
Whether it be Summerfest, EAA, Opening Day, Aaron Water Show,
wherever we may be, you can see us on the radio live from the Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin mobile studio.
We are Wisconsin's radio station.
Wisconsin's radio station.
We are Wisconsin's radio station.
We are Wisconsin's radio station.
WTMJ.
Start your weekend tonight at the Fox and Hound Supper Club with a free dinner, voted the best supper club in the area and most romantic restaurant. WTMJ's John Mercure here. I know because I'm a regular at the Fox and Hounds. It's fantastic. When you buy one dinner, your second dinner is free. The Fox and Hounds is the most affordable and unique dining destination in the state. Tucked into the heart of the Kettle Moraine Forest, the setting is just breathtaking. Order your favorite seafood, steak, pasta, a big fresh salad, steak and lobster,
the ribs, any of it. Your second dinner is free. Desserts and the huge ice cream drinks, buy one, get one free, and I love that chocolate cake. Relax with a hand-muddled old-fashioned, 20 bourbons to choose from, 100 fine wines in one of their 8 elegant dining rooms. The Fox and Hounds, just off Highway 167, 2 miles east of Holy Hill. A spring drive is beautiful in Wisconsin. Weekends might be too busy for some. Enjoy a free dinner tonight. Tables are open. FoxandHoundsRestaurant.com.
They pretty much hurt doing anything. I couldn't ride a bicycle. You don't have your life because you don't have your mobility.
So when Patrick heard about QC Kinetics here in Milwaukee and their non-invasive regenerative treatments for pain, no waiting, he called them immediately.
There's no downtime. There's no rehab. That was the tipping point for me. I didn't have to take any drugs. I didn't have to rehab.
Before considering surgery, check out QC Kinetics' all-natural treatment options that restore and repair damaged joint tissue in your knees, hips, shoulders, and back.
If you have knee replacement surgery and then the knee is not yours, and there's no guarantee that that's going to be successful.
QC Kinetics. Patients around the country are raving about the results. They're getting back their mobility, taking back their lives with no downtime, no drugs, and no surgery. Don't wait. Call QC Kinetics today for your complimentary consultation.
Call QC Kinetics 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Here's to sweet summer days together with friends and family in Wisconsin. To discovering magic in every moment.
Come on, over here.
And to reconnecting through a world filled with wonder.
Wow.
Here's to supper club celebrations and dancing until the sun goes down. Here's to those who Wisconsin. Plan your summer getaway at TravelWisconsin.com.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
One of the things I find interesting when I have conversations like that is sometimes people go, well, why isn't there a different viewpoint in the same hour? Well, I like to focus in depth on these questions. Now, if you listen to the show regularly, you know that Thursday is my legal day of the five. And I've had former Supreme Court justices on. I've had retired judges from Milwaukee County. I've had local attorneys, state attorneys. We get a pretty wide view of all of these issues. Some people are on one side. Some say there are serious charges facing the president. And you heard Rick say a lot of these, he doesn't think a lot of these charges will really hold up. Some might. And then, of course, the public will decide what they do with that information. That is something we do on this program. It's not one-sided. It's not certainly with a lean towards one candidate or another. That's the importance of this hour, and that's why we bring guests on like Rick. Now, to what he said about Wisconsin, interesting conversation there. These constitutional amendments are now going to be the law. And I'm fascinated by that because, as I asked Rick, when you micromanage your state constitution, and Rick correctly pointed out, there's been 100 amendments over time in our state, which still uses a very old version, originalist version of our Constitution, unlike some other places, other states. That reality suggests we will have amendments. My issue with Rick, my issue with that way of problem solving what are perceived issues with how we vote and how our elections are run, where does it end? And if we're going to micromanage all this stuff, it gets very complex trying to figure out what the rules are from election to election. And what Rick and I both agreed on was consistency matters. Same rules across the state, small towns, big cities, rural, urban. And I didn't get a chance to ask Rick this question because we had some phone issues in the middle there. But shouldn't Wisconsin voters have the same consistent ability to vote in the manner they choose to? Not playing games with reducing the number of polling locations, not playing games with drop boxes. And to be honest, I don't know the answer on drop boxes. As Rick correctly pointed out, there's not a language that suggests they should exist, but yet here we are. Now, the pandemic certainly challenged that. And a lot of liberties were taken with how people voted, some of the rules. And as we know now, post-2020, we've all lived with the results, which, looking at talk radio, certainly fueled a hell of a lot of conversations about all of that for the last 4 years almost. So we are now in the sort of the next phase of this. What have we learned from 2020? What do we do with that information? And how do we simplify elections at the same time, making it easier for people to vote accurately, fairly, and get our counts done so the public can accept those results? That's the whole thing. You don't have to like Trump or hate Donald Trump, because all of these candidates in 20 years, they're not going to matter. They'll be different candidates. All of these issues, all of these cases will have historical precedents and context, but we're not going to know that for a long time. The fundamental question we're all going to be looking at this November is it Donald Trump or Joe Biden? And how many people decide to maybe not vote, flip parties, do write-ins, write-in candidates that were competitive at one point in the race and then are no longer candidates. Fascinating question. As a self-declared Nikki Haley supporter, I wrote her in 2020. I have no idea what I'm going to do coming up in this November. And I don't think we know the whole story yet. That's the fascinating part for those of us who talk about politics. It should be the fascinating part for all of us who vote. But here's this. Here's the reality. There's so much else going on that I don't think rises to the level of the importance of this, but it's certainly getting people's attention. Hell, Top Chef gets more attention than the race for president. I don't know that that's the way that I hoped it would go, but that's the reality. And reality TV is consuming most of our brain capacity. My mind, not a good thing. We'll be back tomorrow with the gentleman, Joseph Pecky, Bill McCosian, dissecting what was a very busy week in politics in Wisconsin. I cannot wait to have that conversation with the gentleman on the Political Power Hour Friday edition. The news is next. Right here, Political Power
Hour. In this market, you'll find Fisher Investments is different than other money managers.
Different how? Aren't we all just looking for the hottest stocks?
Nope. We use diversified strategies to position our clients' portfolios for their long-term goals.